A 17-3 run over the final 4 minutes propelled the 25th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team to a come-from-behind 66-52 exhibition victory over Slovakia in the final exhibition game of the 2002 season. Trailing the Slovakian club team 49-48 with 3:52 to play, UCSB sophomore forward Kristen Mann buried a pair of free throws before senior guard Debbie Kane nailed two jumpers, one of them a three-pointer, to give the home team some breathing room. The Gauchos' largest lead came at 63-50, with 41 seconds remaining when Mia Fisher corralled a pass from Jess Hansen for a fast break layup. Kane led all Gaucho scorers with 14 points, 9 in the second half, and made 3 of her 4 shots from behind the arc.
Karina Bonds, the cousin.
After not holding the lead against Flora for the entire length of regulation, the 24th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team rallied for a 73-70 overtime victory Friday night in the Thunderdome.
They find Kristen Mann, left corner, open three. It's too strong. Rebound to Fisher, puts it up strong. Count it! And so good to the line for a three-point opportunity. Gauchos are down three. Inside pass, Mann to Saar. Layup up the glass and good. And the Gauchos are within one. And stops. Now spins it to the top. Stevenson. Open three. Wide open shot. Got it from downtown. Stevenson with a long three. Florida Gators skip pass right. Mosby high arcing. Bomb and it goes in. And set up the offense on the point. Shot clock at 15. Mia Fisher to the cup. Lays it off the glass and good. What a point. Point. Player to player defense by the Gauchos. They trap at the top. Spin it left side. Williams open three. Got it from downtown. Continuing. Gauchos are now 4 of 8 from the line. Williams left corner three, buried it from outside. Williams from downtown. Stevenson back to low, right corner, open three.
The Gauchos playing their 2002-2003 home opener, and it's their first overtime game since a 103-90 loss at Wisconsin on November 20th, 1998, improved to 2-1 on the young season.
Gauchos 0 for 4 from downtown. Fisher with the rebound, puts it up in traffic and puts it in. Away by Lowe. For Florida, 9 turnovers on UCSB. Cross court to left to Williams. Baseline shot. Yes, this time she has it. Seconds low. Shakes and bakes. One-on-one against Bonds. Clock at 7. Working in the lane. Low stops at the foul line. 15-footer on the way. Rimming around, and it goes in with 2 seconds left. One. Half-court bomb by Willett. It is off the mark. No good. Engel drives down the baseline. Stopped by Stevenson. Goes back down the baseline. Shot blocked by Hayden, and the loose ball controlled by Florida. Here they come. It's a 2-on-1. Low lost the ball, got it back, spins it right to Taylor. Open three, good.
What are you telling?
Sophomores, 50-35, a 15-point game, the biggest lead. Willett at the top for three. She got it from downtown. Lisa Willett with her is inside. Richardson to the cup, lays it up and in. Richardson bounce pass inside Davis, knocked away, taken away by the Gauchos. Turnover number 13. Gauchos have it. Here's Richardson up the floor to Fisher. 2-on-1. Fisher to the cup. Lays it up and in. Gauchos on a 4-0 run. Fisher down the lane all the way to the basket. Lays it up off the glass and good. Instead of an 8-point game. A timeout Florida.
Good defensive.
Kind of a sagging man defense by the Gators. Here is a three put up and in. Inbound on the baseline.
Trailing 61-49 with 9:28 remaining in regulation, UCSB outscored the Gators 13-1 to tie the score at 62-all. Sophomore forward Kristen Mann, who led Santa Barbara with 18 points, scored 7 points during Santa Barbara's run to close the second half. She nailed a three-point basket with 1:58 to go, and that cut the lead to 62-61. Then with 1:10 remaining, junior center Lindsay Taylor made 1 out of 2 free throws to tie the score. Both Mann and Taylor had chances to score as time wound down, but each attempt fell short, and the two teams headed into an extra period.
To the top is Kane, 7 seconds into Mann. Turnaround shot with the right hand off the mark. Rebound Taylor puts it up, and no good. Rebound Florida, and we go to overtime here at the Thunderdome. Time for us, the toss, the tap. And
Mann gave the Gauchos their first lead of the entire contest, hitting a short bank shot with 4:47 to go. The basket gave the home team its first lead of the game at 64-62. Florida, which had gone nearly 10 minutes without a field goal, tied the game at 64-all on a baseline jumper from Sarah Lowe. Danielle Santos gave the Gators their final lead of the game at the 3:23 mark when she scored on a 12-footer. With 1:30 left, the Gauchos reclaimed the lead at 70-68 on a driving layup by Brandi Richardson. With just 20 seconds to go, Hansen scored a baseline lane, giving UCSB a 72-70 lead. Following a Florida turnover, Hansen was fouled and sunk one of two free throws to make it 73-70 Gauchos. A last-second three-point attempt by Mosby did not draw iron, as Santa Barbara held on for the win.
Right side Stevenson, 3 seconds. Mosby, shot for three, and it's high, no good! And the Gauchos hang on to win it! The Gauchos come back from 15 down in the second half to beat Florida, 73-70.
In one of the most exciting women's basketball games the Thunderdome has ever hosted, UC Santa Barbara upset 6th-ranked Purdue 83-82 in overtime. After the visiting Boilermakers tied the game at 73-73 with 0.4 seconds left in regulation, following an improbable bank shot three-pointer by Julie forward Lindsey Hicks, the Gauchos wouldn't allow any such miracles in the extra frame and improved their record to 4-1 in the young season.
It's 4-on-3. Fisher down the lane. Stop. Leans inside. Shoots it on the way. Count it. And so good of the line for a three-point play. Fisher in transition. Hansen has it in the left corner. Puts up a three again. She got it again. 2 for 2 for Hansen. There's a leg. Makes the pass left, looks inside, will it down low, touch pass, beautiful shot, he put it in, and still count it for one, the trail of nine for a three-point opportunity, alley-oop lob to Willett, the bucket, and the horn. Finds Hansen, shot clock at 15, Hansen at the top, swings the left to Willett, inside pass, Taylor, bounce pass, now bouncer into the paint, count it, and a foul, the trail of nine, 4-on-3, into Taylor, turnaround shot with the left hand, good, Taylor! Purdue Boilermakers here at the Thunderdome. Left of the circle, Kane, inside pass, high lob to Taylor, puts it up and in, Taylor with... Kane right of the circle, inside pass to Taylor, and knocking her down was Noon, and Noon has just fouled out of the game, and she knocks down Taylor, Noon's fifth personal, she's out of the game.
She doesn't want to leave, she's got a few things to say to the official.
CSB, 3-on-2, in transition, Hike is running, and the shot blocked away by Hansen, out of bounds! Stay with Purdue. What a transition defensive play by Hansen.
Well, that's a nice
Purdue 67. Second shot on the way. Yes.
Yeah, the game showing some experience.
Gauchos in the left corner. It's right. Takes the three. Now she'll take the three and she misses. Rebound. Purdue cannot get the rebound. Brady Richardson's got
the Gauchos, playing Purdue for the third time since March of 2001, appeared headed for their first triumph over the defending Big Ten Conference champs in regulation. When UCSB senior guard Jess Hansen nailed one of two free throw attempts with 37 seconds left in the second half, the scoreboard read 72-67 in favor of the home team. The two teams then traded timeouts before the Boilermakers worked the clock under 10 seconds and got the ball into the hands of junior guard Beth Jones, who was fouled by Hansen on a three-point attempt from the right wing. Jones calmly sunk all three free throws, and Santa Barbara junior Lisa Willett was immediately fouled on the second of her two freebies with 5 seconds left, setting the stage for Hicks' coast-to-coast drive and dramatic basket. Purdue had trailed for the final 16-33 of regulation before knotting the score and forcing an additional period.
Across half court, 3 seconds, takes it to the top for three for the tie.
The Boilermakers maintained their momentum at the start of the overtime, pulling ahead 75-74 when junior All-American candidate Sharika Wright buried two shots from the charity stripe. However, the Gauchos responded with 4 straight points, capped by a backdoor driving layup by senior guard Debbie Kane. Santa Barbara's lead then increased to 80-76 when Brandi Richardson made 2 free throws with 1:44 left. Hicks pulled Purdue within a bucket on her squad's next possession, and the visitors showed they still had plenty of life left when Jones gave the Boilermakers an 81-80 advantage by burying a tray at the 51-second mark. On its next trip down the floor, UCSB worked 20 seconds off of the clock before Hansen picked the most opportune time for her career-high tying 6th 3-pointer of the game. With 2 players already fouled out and 2 others with 4 personals, the Boilermakers couldn't afford a second overtime and played for the final shot. Their initial attempt rimmed out, but sophomore forward Emily Heights grabbed the offensive rebound and was fouled on the putback.
And now she has to go to the free throw line. Now these are very difficult free throws.
seconds to go. Hike is to the line. 72% foul shooter. Now goes by two, 83-81. A second and a half to go. The foul shot is up, and it's good. Nothing but net from Hikens.
The 2,683 fans in attendance grew nervous as Hikes made her first free throw, but her second shot drew iron and was corralled by UCSB sophomore forward Brandon Richardson. Purdue was the highest-ranked opponent Santa Barbara has defeated since its upset of number 5 Florida in the Thunderdome on November 30th, 1997.
The 21st-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team concluded its 2002-2003 non-conference home schedule with a convincing 72-57 victory over USC before a crowd of 2,759 in the Thunderdome. The Gauchos' fourth consecutive victory was also their 16th straight win at home and improved the squad's overall record to 9-2. With the victory, UCSB ran its all-time record against the women of Troy to 12-9. Debbie Kane's three-pointer gave Santa Barbara an early 5-0 lead, and the home team held USC at bay until a layup by senior forward Ebony Hoffman gave the Trojans their only lead of the game at 21-19 with 7:05 remaining before halftime. The visitors scored again at the 5:18 mark, but would be shut out the rest of the way as UCSB went on a 13-0 run to close the period and take a 36-23 lead into the locker rooms. Sophomore guard Mia Fisher tallied 7 points during the aforementioned spurt. Gauchos sophomore forward Brandy Richardson, who finished with a career-high 17 rebounds, grabbed 12 boards in the first half compared to just 11 by the entire USC team. The shooting woes continued for the women of Troy at the outset of the second half before Alicia Hollins ended it over an 8-minute offensive drought with a layup at the 16:56 mark. Santa Barbara responded with a 3-point courtesy of Lisa Willett and a lay-in by Lindsay Taylor to grab their largest lead, 47-25, with 12:42 left to play. A string of 7 unanswered points cut USC's deficit to 12 at the 1:56 mark before Kane put an exclamation point in the victory with another tray from the left wing. Fisher led the Gauchos in scoring for the first time all season with 17 points and was nearly flawless on the evening by sinking 5 of her 6 shots and all 7 free throws. Richardson notched her 4th career double-double by scoring 11 points, the total matched by Lisa Willett. Taylor and Kane contributed 10 points apiece for UCSB, which nailed 21 of 25 free throws and won the Battle of the Boards 49-28. After the Trojans game, Santa Barbara had out-rebounded its last 3 opponents by a collective 149-83 margin. Lindsay Taylor scored a career-high 30 points, and Jess Hansen became the 17th player in UC Santa Barbara women's basketball history to record 1,000 points as the 19th-ranked Gauchos defeated Long Beach State 70-48 in the Thunderdome. UCSB's 19th consecutive home victory raised its overall record to 15-3, and gives them a 1.5 game lead in the Big West Conference standings at 8-1. A crowd of just over 3,000 people, the largest in the Thunderdome this season, witnessed the UCSB-LBSU showdown. Taylor scored the game's first 7 points, opening with a three-pointer from the top of the key. As the home team built a lead it would never relinquish, LBSU could not find its shooting touch, making just 2 of its first 23 shots and trailing 26-5 with 6:10 remaining before the halftime. After Taylor buried a pair of free throws, the 49ers recovered slightly from their early shooting woes by trailing 36-16 heading into the locker room and shot just 16%. The closest Long Beach could pull after halftime was 55-38 with 9:22 to play, at which point UCSB embarked on an 8-0 run. The spurt was capped by Hansen's historic three-pointer from the right corner at the 7:02 mark that put her at the 1,000-point plateau for her career. Taylor led Santa Barbara in scoring for the 12th time this season, while sophomore forward Kristen Mann produced her second double-double in as many games with 15 points and 11 rebounds. Sophomore forward Brandy Richardson recorded double-digit rebounds for the 10th time this season by hauling in a dozen boards. Meanwhile, junior forward Lisa Willett continued to emerge from a mid-season shooting slump by scoring 10 points. The 17th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team avenged its only Big West Conference loss of the season by cruising past Pacific 66-37. By atoning for a 74-65 upset at the hands of UOP last month, the Gauchos extended their lead in the Big West standings to 2 full games at 9-1 and also own a 16-3 overall record courtesy of their 20th consecutive home victory. Pacific junior forward Jillian DeHout scored the first 2 baskets of the game, and UCSB did not hold the lead until junior center Lindsay Taylor made the score 11-9 with a layup at the 9:09 mark at the beginning of the opening half. The second of Kristen Mann's 3 first half three-pointers then gave the home team a 16-3 cushion before Pacific took its final lead of the game thanks to back-to-back short-range jumpers by DeHout and senior forward Ashiek Johnson. Santa Barbara responded by scoring 14 unanswered points to close the first half. Senior guard Debbie Kane put an exclamation point on the run by going coast to coast and scoring a scoop shot layup with just 2 seconds showing on the clock. The Gauchos took a 32-17 lead into the locker rooms, marking the 7th time this season they had held an opponent below 20 points and a half. UOP scored 6 of the first 8 points following intermission, 4 on free throws by DeHaus, to narrow the gap to 34-23 at the 15-25 mark. However, UCSB topped its impressive spurt in the first half by going on an incredible 18-0 run that lasted over 7 minutes. Shortly after the aforementioned run ended, Santa Barbara built a 32-point advantage as Mann fed senior guard Jess Hansen for a wide-open trail and then scored herself on a nifty fast-break lane. Mann led all scorers by pouring in 17 points, making 7 of 14 shots. Taylor was the only other Goucher to score in double figures, and she had 11, while Hansen and sophomore guard Mia Fisher contributed 8 points apiece. For the 14th time in 2002-2003, Richardson was UCSB's top rebounder by hauling down 11 boards.
Center on the campus of LSU.
In a game that no superlatives could ever accurately describe, the 4th-ranked LSU women's basketball team outlasted number 17 UC Santa Barbara 94-90 in a triple overtime thriller in the Pete Maravich Assembly Center.
Trying to shake the defender, fades
after playing their third overtime contest in the 2002-2003 season and their second triple overtime affair in school history, the Gauchos had their seven-game winning streak snapped and fell to 18-4 on the season.
Richardson at the top.
This non-conference contest was about 16 ties, 14 lead changes, and clutch shots on both ends of the court.
Donika Hodges, dribbling to the free throw line. Pull-up jumper, yep, 46 left in the half. Tardy from the key, good. Oh, what a pretty bucket inside, in traffic. Fish has had a great crowd in the Maravich jump shot. Nice double pass that time, coming inside. There's the easy catch of the bucket for Lindsay Tadakpa. Fisher shaking in the lane, fakes left, comes up and scores. Hansen, yep. Win last year in the first round of the NCAA playoffs on a late bucket by Hansen. Man looking inside. Oh, what a battle there is down there. Bodying up. Lindsay Taylor wins it over Smith. Position. Man down to Taylor. Man wants it back. Taylor spins left and scoops it in. Nice move by the 6. Shoots over Smith. Got it. Oh, she tough.
Excited with somebody like this. Watch the head fake. Look at the position. When sees that she will not get the pressure by Asa Smith, the quick release. That's fabulous weapons for UCSB to have
by a pair. Augustus for the tie. No. Saved by Hodges. Turn around. Good. Short range
on the offense as Aisha Smith gets the steal, and a nice job by 6'5 Crystal White to get the ball in the blocks, take it up strong, and you see a little bit of the emotion now coming back with LSU as they take the lead.
She passes up to three. Man's got the look, doesn't she? Working inside, faking, fading, and scoring. Hodges, Smith, yes, left side for three.
The right of your screen, and here comes Aisha Smith from the top of the key down, just wants it more.
Take points, and Smith can't complete the free throw. Two possession lead for the Lady Tigers. They double up Hanson.
There would have been no first overtime if not for the heroics of UC Santa Barbara senior Jess Hanson. Trailing 62-60 with under 10 seconds to play, the Gauchos got a defensive stop and fed the ball to their senior guard, who drove the length of the left sideline and banked in a layup with just 0.3 tick shilling on the scoreboard.
3/10 of a second left, and we are tied at 62, and we go to overtime. Hanson gets the last
bucket. On the bench now, and she's gone back to the regular starting lineup. They had a nice job.
Kiki Tardy has been silent until then.
Then during the initial extra frame, Kristen Mann's lay-in at the 101 mark put the visitors ahead 68-66, and LSU couldn't convert on its ensuing possession. The Lady Tigers then intentionally fouled Lisa Willett, sending her to the free throw line to shoot 1-1 and potentially put her squad ahead by 4. The junior forward missed the front end, giving the home team another chance with 22 seconds to play. The Tigers got the ball into the hands of junior point guard Tamika Johnson, who converted on a short jumper inside the key. That left UCSB 8 seconds to get off a final shot, but Brandi Richardson was stripped by LSU Simone Augustus, whose 65-foot desperation heave was online but sailed over the backboard.
Aisha Smith with more on the defensive end. 4 minutes and some change. Augustus hanging, scoring!
Santa Barbara's chances for the biggest upset in program history appeared to have finally run out in the second overtime, as Danica Hodges' three-pointer with 2:26 on the clock gave the Lady Tigers a 78-70 advantage. Hanson immediately answered with another one of her 5 trays, and Mann trimmed the deficit to 3 with a jump shot from the left baseline. Johnson made the scoreboard read 80-75 at the 127 mark,
before Gaucho's sophomore guard Mia Fisher buried a 12-footer.
Drop steps and knocks it down. Gaucho fire. Short. It's tipped around, controlled by the visitors. Think about getting that quick shot, then take the chances at the free throw line with LSU. This is Hanson, and Johnson will not give an inch.
After holding LSU without a score, it was again Hanson's turn to shine with yet another three-pointer with 12 seconds remaining. The Tigers again couldn't convert, and the 2,348 fans in attendance were treated five more minutes of epic basketball.
And you'll see the rotation right here. She sees nobody in front of her. And there it goes. And that is pure time as she gets the defender to fall down and to be able to spin in one motion.
As it did in the first two overtime periods, LSU caught fire in the opening salvo of the third, thanks to two of the senior center Aisha Smith's career-high 30 points and a swish by Augustus. Not surprisingly, Hanson came through with another triple before Richardson nailed the jumper in traffic to give the visitors an 85-84 lead with 2:46 remaining. The Lady Tigers storm back with a 5-0 run and appear to have all of the momentum in their favor before senior guard Debbie Kane, who like Hanson had played all of overtime and four fouls, connected on Trey for her only points of the ball game to pull UCSB back within 89-88 at the 43-second mark. The visitors were then forced to foul, and LSU obviously learned from its collapse in the second overtime by sinking five of its six free throws. All the Gaucho offense could muster were two freebies by Hanson and the 11 seconds left to make the score 92-90. But Augustus hit a pair of her own to give the game its final score.
Team has been amazing. Both of these teams so resilient.
In UCSB's highest scoring contest of the season, Mann equaled her career high of 27 points. The Santa Ana, California native added 12 rebounds in her ninth career double-double. Hanson scored a season-high 23 points, while Fisher chipped in 13. Also scoring 13 points was junior center Lindsay Taylor, who grabbed 9 rebounds as well before fouling out with 3:28 to play in the second half. Santa Barbara won the battle on the boards, 53-46.
Did not want it. Allows UC Santa Barbara,
and that is two free throws.
Hanson is 2 for 2 today, now 3 for 3. She's got the eyes of a competitor, doesn't she?
Right here, Bob is going to get all over as soon as the ball gets thrown in.
You betcha. And they foul, 7 seconds remaining. If she misses, who knows what may happen. LSU does not want a foul here. Fisher, 8 seconds. 6. Hanson's 28-footer off the back iron. 3 seconds. Mann misses. It's over. In 3 overtimes, LSU survives. 94-90 over California Santa Barbara. And look at Sue Gunner. She shakes her head and will get a big hug from Mark French.
The 17th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team defeated UC Riverside 76-36, becoming the first squad in school history to finish the season undefeated at home. The Gauchos went 13-0 at the Thunderdome in 2002-2003 and extended their home winning streak to 23 straight, currently tied for the third longest in the nation.
UCSB concluded its regular season at 23-4 and 15-1 in the Big West Conference. Guards Debbie Kane and Jess Hansen were honored in a senior night ceremony prior to the tip-off, and Kane promptly commenced the evening scoring with a three-pointer from the left wing. Santa Barbara opened the game on a 10-0 run and made its first eight shots from the floor, reminiscent of its last game against Cal State Fullerton, in which the squad went 9-for-9 at the outset. A layup by Lindsay Taylor at the 15-32 mark gave the Gauchos a 15-4 advantage, one that would not dip into single digits the rest of the way. The home team displayed excellent ball movement in the first half, as all 16 UCSB baskets came via an assist. Santa Barbara shot a blistering 73% from the floor before halftime and took a 42-16 lead into the locker rooms. The Highlanders' point total over the opening 20 minutes equaled the seventh fewest allowed in a half in Gaucho history. With the outcome never in question, the highlight of the second half came courtesy of Hansen, who buried her final three-pointer in the Thunderdome with 4:10 to play, bringing the season-high crowd of 3,181 to its collective feet. For the fourth consecutive game, Taylor reached the 20-point plateau and recorded her fifth double-double of the season with a game-high 22 points and 10 boards. Sophomore forward Kristen Mann scored 17 to go along with her 7 boards and 5 assists, while junior Lisa Willett added 11 points and made 2 of 3 shots from behind the arc. Kane and Hansen dished off 4 helpers apiece and finished with 5 and 6 points respectively.
Richardson for UCSB. High-low lob inside Taylor. Left-hand layup is good. She ties the game.
Records were meant to be broken, and the 17th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team did a lot of smashing in its 2003 Big West Conference tournament opener against Cal State Fullerton. The top-seeded and 6-time defending champion Gauchos cruised to a 93-58 quarterfinal win, their widest victory margin in 35 years of league tourney play dating back to 1984. UCSB shot 60% from the floor, its top performance in the 20-year history of the event, and ninth best in any game in school history, en route to improving to 22-4 on the season. Four of the team's 10 most efficient field goal performances in program history have come in the 2003 season alone. The Gauchos allowed Fullerton to remain within striking distance for much of last year's Big West first-round game in Anaheim, and history seemed to repeat itself at the outset of the game. A three-pointer by Allison Offelt, sandwiched between two baskets from Nikki Lee, gave Cal State Fullerton a 7-2 advantage just over 2 minutes into the first half. However, junior Lisa Willett answered with a tough turnaround jumper on UCSB's next trip down the court before senior guard Jess Hansen buried back-to-back three-pointers to give the tournament favorites their first lead of the night at 10-7 with 16:30 to play. The Titans scored on their ensuing possession, but Santa Barbara then embarked on a 14-0 run that lasted over 6 minutes. Sophomore forward Kristen Mann scored 6 of her 14 points during that spurt. However, Cal State Fullerton still had some fight left, pulling within 75-56 when Rochelle Ortega capped a 12-4 run with a short layup at the 4:16 mark. That would be the closest the underdogs would get, as Santa Barbara turned on the afterburners with a 19-2 run to close the contest. It was the Gauchos reserves time to shine, as Karina Bonds nailed 6 free throws, sophomore Hattie Saar tallied all 7 of her points, and Roshana Perkins capped the evening scoring with a pair of free throws with just 6 seconds left on the clock. All 10 Santa Barbara players scored at least 2 points, with the team's five starters each amassing double digits. Taylor finished with the game-high 21 on 9 of 12 shooting, making the fifth consecutive time she has reached the 20-point plateau. Sophomore guard Mia Fisher poured in 12, while Hanson and Richardson contributed 10 and 11 points respectively. While Richardson grabbed a game-best 7 rebounds, UC Santa Barbara lost the battle of the boards 34-33. However, the Gauchos were a more careful team this evening, dishing off 21 assists with only 51 turnovers.
They have the opening possession of the game, their second possession of the game. Hanson to the cup and lays it in transition. The secondary break works to get past left.
Jess Hanson scored 16 points and Mia Fisher added 15 to lead UC Santa Barbara past UC Irvine 83-50 in the Big West semifinals. Lindsay Taylor contributed 13 points, while Brandy Richardson had 11 points and 10 rebounds for the 17th-ranked Gauchos.
From the defender, floating right-hander, short, got her own board, puts it up strong, and puts it in. Timeout, Irvine.
Good effort on the second shot there.
With the win, Santa Barbara notched its 20th consecutive conference tournament victory over the past seven seasons. Wendy Gaby scored a game-high 17 points, while reserve Courtney Ferguson added 13 points for the 8-eaters. Santa Barbara shot 53% from the floor and made 64% of its three-point field goal attempts.
15-footer, yes, it rolls in there. Shot clock, Hanson at the top, a long three. Oh, it put it in! 2 minutes to go, first half, right block Willett. Backdoor pass, inside Taylor, layup, good! Fisher at the foul line, steps inside, floating right-hander, miss, rebound, Richardson puts it up strong and puts it in. Richardson clean. In the right corner, inside the man, layup, good.
That's where she's so tough.
Irvine shot just 31% from the field and committed 17 turnovers. UCSB advanced to its seventh straight Big West tourney championship game.
Wide open shot, banks it in off the glass. A nice interior pass left. Richardson's got it. Not closely guarded. She'll take another three. She hit it again! Her third three of the game! She had only two all season. She has three in this game alone. Two on one to Fisher. Driving layup. Right hand. It is good! Count it! And she'll go to the line for one.
Unselfish play by Jess Hanson. Probably could have dribbled.
Inbound. Finds Sturgeon. Layup is good at the buzzer. And that's it. A walk in the park once again for the Gaucho women's basketball team. They win. Final score, UCSB 83, UC Irvine 50. Irvine's season is over. The Gauchos once again move on to the title game.
Seven proved to be a lucky number for the 17th-ranked UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team, which earned its unprecedented seventh consecutive Big West Conference Tournament Championship by defeating Pacific 68-50 in the Anaheim Convention Center. The victory improved the Gauchos' overall record to 26-4 and advanced the Gauchos automatically into the 64-team NCAA tournament for the seventh consecutive year. Consistent with recent UCSB-UOP battles, the first half was a competitive affair, although neither squad shot the ball particularly well.
Karina Bonds, left side, corner shot for Dingus of the three, and she puts it in. Backs in.
After Pacific tied the score at 5-5, thanks to center Alicia Smith's short-range jumper with 16:06 to play, the Gauchos stormed out to a 14-3 run, ignited by a three-pointer by Lisa Willett from the left baseline. UOP quickly pulled back within 10 and then got as close as 23-22 at the 3:07 mark when Nancy Dingus capped a string of seven unanswered points with an uncontested trip. However, the Tigers would manage just one more point while shooting just 27% in the first half.
At the top, Willett for three. It's short, rebound. Taylor puts it up strong, and she puts it in. Count it, and she'll get to the line for more. Ball fought for. Ewing had it.
lost it out to Dingus. Wide open corner three, and she put it in. The Gauchos' goal. Kane finds Willett. Bounce step into the lane. Shot is up and missed. Rebound Kane. Shot at the buzzer. She got it! She got it!
The UCSB to Debbie Kane running jumper with 1.1 seconds left on the clock to carry a 30-23 lead and the game's momentum into the locker rooms. Santa Barbara atoned for a 33% shooting performance in the first half by scoring on its first three possessions after the intermission, including a Brandy Richardson three-pointer from the top of the key that made the scoreboard read 37-27. On the other end of the court, Pacific finally got its offense in gear as well and pulled to within 43-34 with 15:30 to play after junior forward Jillian DeHout scored two of a game-high 20 points. At that point, UCSB delivered the knockout punch with an 11-0 run that spanned over 5 minutes. At the 5:47 mark, Gaucho junior center Lindsay Taylor was whistled for her fifth personal foul, but her team was firmly in control with a 58-38 advantage. Santa Barbara then put an exclamation point on its 21st consecutive Big West tournament victory by scoring five unanswered points to build a 68-42 cushion, its largest of the afternoon. Leading the Gauchos on offense with 17 points was sophomore forward Kristen Mann, while Taylor added 16 points and also grabbed 12 rebounds, 11 of which came before halftime for her 15th career double-double. Taylor repeated as Big West Tournament Most Valuable Player and was joined on the all-tournament team by Mann and senior teammate Jess Hansen, who scored in double figures in the first two tourney games and amassed 7 points in the finals. As a team, UCSB dished off 11 assists and committed a season-low 6 turnovers.
And they're going to the big dance again.
With us on the NCAA Women's Tournament Selection Special. I'm Reese Davis, along with my partners Nell Fortner and Stacey Dale Schumann. Ladies, it is an exciting day, and certainly we have a lot of exciting things to talk about today. You know, for the first time, ESPN will bring you all 63 games on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPN Full Court. Jaspers out of the MAAC, the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference, making their first tournament appearance since 1996 and their fourth all time.
Also in Midwest, these games will be played in 11 countries. The 7th seed, UC Santa Barbara, taking up the 7th seed. UC Santa Barbara, many people feel this is an underrated, underappreciated team. Lindsay Taylor, Player of the Year in that conference. They will be taking on Xavier, a 20-game winner, and led by Tara Booth, who is the A-10 Rookie of the Year. The 2th seed in the Midwest.
Teams led by Elena Beer, Isis Hillis.
And what they do is they cluster you on defense. You see here the steal by... Team. UC Santa Barbara's going to a little 1-4 high.
Mia Fisher scored 14 points as UC Santa Barbara beat Xavier 71-62 in a first-round Midwest regional game in the United Spirit Arena in the first round of the NCAA tournament. The Gauchos never trailed in building a 12-point lead in the first half. Then they watched as a feisty 10th-seeded Xavier team pulled within one early in the second period at 33-32 on a layup by Amy Waugh. The two teams later exchanged 6-0 runs, giving the Gauchos a 53-43 lead with 8:43 remaining. The Musketeers trimmed the margin to 6 points at 68-62 with 31.9 seconds remaining on a free throw by Waugh. But a free throw by Kristen Mann and two by Debbie Kane sealed the game for the Gauchos.
A sophomore junior college
Toronto, one and done for Xavier.
In transition, Willett blows by everybody.
Transition defense, you've got to
kick it in to Taylor. Kick it back out to Brandy. Taylor, good position inside. Meanwhile, Xavier, 28% from the floor. Fisher in transition.
Fisher does a good play. They're quick enough and tall enough.
Long rebound out to Fisher. Slices through the defense.
Leon Fisher.
Free. Henderson sights up the three and hits it.
Rebound, the shot clock went off, but it was not a violation.
Lindsay Taylor scored 13 points, and Mann and Jess Hansen each added 12 points of their own for the seven-seeded UC Santa Barbara team, which led 33-27 at halftime. The Gauchos led 32-20 with 3:55 left in the first half, before the Musketeers closed the margin to 6 on a 7-1 run. Waugh scored 19 points, and Tara Booth added 16 and pulled down 12 rebounds for the Musketeers. With the victory, UC Santa Barbara advanced to the second round of the NCAA tournament for the second straight season, where it would face off with number 2 Texas Tech, who was a 67-59 winner over 15th-seeded Southwest Missouri State.
She came on and really sparked them to their run in the first half as Kristen Mann hits the jumper. Sure. And Mia pulls up in transition and hits. Mia Fisher now with 10 points. Debbie Kane stepping into the passing lane. And she'll take it end to end. Mann pulls up over Booth. Kristen Mann taking over.
Going to the rebound the ball out and getting it into Wall's hand, letting her shoot the three ball.
She puts another one up and hits, and she is all fired up for the Musketeers.
Taylor inside.
Hansen. Jess Hansen finally breaking free. Hansen, unattended, knocks down another one. Was three attempts around and out. UC Santa Barbara trying to waste some time. The shot clock is off.
To advance against Texas Tech, but in front of a hostile crowd here Tuesday night. Mark Frinson here.
12 of 14. Now 13 of 15 from the line here in the second half. 15 of her 20 points have been in the second half. Around and out again with the three, and that'll do it. UC Santa Barbara moves on. They will face Texas Tech in the second round here in the Midwest region. Now let's go to Reese Davis. Well, the other 3-2 seeds have all...
An incredible season for the UC Santa Barbara women's basketball team culminated in a stirring final game. But the 17th-ranked Gauchos unfortunately found themselves on the losing end of a 72-68 decision to number 7 Texas Tech in a second-round NCAA tournament battle at the United Spirit Arena. A thrilling back-and-forth affair did not appear to be in the cards at the outset of the first half as TTU stormed out to a 23-8 lead at the 11-18 mark, thanks largely to the hot shooting of junior centers Gianna Perkins and Natalie Ritchie.
And they just keep wanting to shoot the ball. Get aggressive, not to, just to change defenses.
But check that man trying to work inside. Switches to the left hand and scores.
Really nice.
The SB trying to stay alive here in the first half after Texas Tech came out strong.
Meanwhile, Gaucho junior center Lindsay Taylor, the Big West Conference Player of the Year, was saddled with three personal fouls within the opening 10 minutes. UCSB finally got its offense in gear with a 13-4 run, capped by a fast break layup by sophomore guard Mia Fisher that made the scoreboard read 27-21 with 6:21 remaining before intermission.
Now Fisher on
The two teams traded baskets for the remainder of the period, and the Gauchos went into the locker room at intermission, trailing 38-30.
You've had the lead, but let me tell you.
Hanson. Blows by Tennant.
Oh, but don't give her the ball right inside the three-ball line.
Hanson hits for three using the Richardson screen. Out right now with three personal fouls. She has scored 9 points, though, in the half. As Hanson hits another three, her second of the game. Perkins pull up from 15. Good defense by Fisher to make it a tough shot. Hanson, the launch. Off the front of the rim. The two seed will head into the locker room with a 38-30 lead here in Lubbock.
Santa Barbara commenced the second half with the same intensity with which it ended the first, tallying four unanswered points and pulling within 44-43 at the 15-51 mark when Fisher once again scored in transition.
Inside, Taylor rebounds her own miss and puts it up and in. Taylor, another offensive rebound in the putback. She's missed her last five three-point attempts, and Fisher right back at him.
What body balance. Can you?
Texas Tech remained on top until Hanson buried her third three-pointer of the game with 12:49 remaining to knot things up at 50-all. After misfiring on its next trip down the court, the Gauchos grabbed their first lead of the entire contest when junior Lisa Willett drove the baseline for 2 points. From that point forward, this epic clash embodied the phrase March Madness, as neither squad allowed the other team to amass an advantage of more than 4 points.
Blocked by the bottom of the backboard. Greenwald got the rebound, put it up and missed. She got fouled, and she'll shoot two. Kissy Greenwald, the 6'5 center. And who's the foul on?
On Jess Hanson, it's a fifth foul.
Oh, no.
With Hanson having fouled out after scoring 17 points, Taylor took over offensively for UCSB. The Chandler, Arizona native scored 6 straight points for her team, including a turnaround jumper at the 5:56 mark that puts Santa Barbara ahead 61-59. However, the Lady Raiders, playing in front of 11,080 rabid fans, stormed back with a 5-0 run of their own over the next minute and a half, capped by a Casey Jackson jump shot. The home team held at least a 2-point cushion for the next 3 minutes and upped it to 4 when senior All-American candidate Plente Pearson drove baseline for 2 of her 15 points with just 27 seconds remaining. On the brink of elimination, Debbie Kane drove the lane for UCSB, then found a wide-open Kristen Mann, who swished a three-pointer from the left wing to pull within 69-68 with just 15 seconds remaining. Gaucho head coach Mark French immediately called his final timeout and then watched sophomore forward Brandy Richardson foul Pearson. The TTU star calmly drained both freebies, leaving Santa Barbara with 13 seconds in which to try and knot the score with another dramatic tread.
And they find Pearson in the backcourt. They're trying to get a steal. They get a foul with 13.3 seconds to play. And in. Pearson has 14. Gaucho's inbound, 12 seconds. Kane at the floor. Across the midcourt stripes, 9 seconds. Kane at the top gets a screen. Needs help. 6 seconds.
The ball once again found its way to Kristen Mann on the left wing. However, her high arcing shot drew iron, and Pearson nailed another free throw to ice the victory with less than a second to play. Taylor poured in 17 of her game-high 26 points in the second half, one shy of the highest single game total by a Gaucho in NCAA tournament play. In addition to Hanson's 17, Mann and Fisher each scored 9. Fisher added a career-high 9 rebounds, a figure matched by Taylor, as Santa Barbara won the Battle of the Boards 43-36. In addition, Kane, playing in her final collegiate game along with Hanson, dished off a game-high 6 assists while committing only 2 turnovers. UCSB, seeded 7th in the Midwest region, was unsuccessful yet again in their bid for a first-ever Sweet 16 appearance and concluded their 2002-2003 campaign with an impressive 27-5 overall record. That record equals the second most wins in program history, as well as the second best winning percentage ever by a Santa Barbara team.
Everything went against them. It seemed like no matter what, they couldn't get a call to go their way. They continue to fight back Lindsay Taylor in the foul trouble in the first half. Jess Hanson fouls out early in the second half. Just nothing would go, and they continue to just put on a tremendous show here.
navigator of your destiny. Where is the dealer of this hand? Who can explain life and its brevity? 'Cause there is nothing here that I can understand. Barely met, and I just don't want to let go of you yet. No, hello, goodbye. I'll see you on the other side. Face. Heaven calls
Hanson for three. She got it!